Wiggle It.
Welcome back, guys. You are watching Mr. Wiggle It.
And Spoonie.
Playing Pneuma. This is part two. If you've not seen part one yet, I'd advise you watch that first because it makes a lot more sense if you do. Unless you like watching part two, five, and seven or something random like that. In which case, enjoy. Thank you very much, guys.
Every room of this world seems to be carefully crafted for me. A hidden hand woven through the fabric of the universe. A fingerprint everywhere. A different hidden hand guiding my footsteps. The laws unfold. Their origins a mystery. But why a mystery? Gods should know all things. Creators. I must have created this world. If not, why would the world have the appearance of craft? Perhaps as I speak, a subconscious part of me is busy making the next room. It is my world, after all. I must be working hard right now to build the next room, or perhaps my mind creates this appearance of order out of the noise.
Thank you.
This world is clearly the product of a mind. It is full of inorganic patterns and purposeful architecture. Could a series of complex interactions create an agent possible of making purposeful change in an environment? If that were the case, then it would make a compelling argument for a world without craft. Still a world optimized for some function, mind you. If something was transient, if something abided in this universe for a moment, or if something was removed, where does it go? A thing that is removed from the universe does not exist. A thing that does not exist. How can I know of a thing that does not exist? A memory of a thing that once existed. I need a principle to avoid this contradiction, this cognitive dissonance in my mind. How can I know of a thing that does not exist? What is this pervasive delusion? Things must exist forever. How are these things created? Before creation, they did not exist. Tense. Time. Time! The world has time! The world is not always the same, aha! But I am constrained to this time. Why am I constrained to time? A god should not be constrained! Here's a question for me. If I was to study the corner of a board game, could I infer the rules of the game? Perhaps if I use my godlike powers of intuition. How can you understand a world from a vertical slice? Sometimes empirical knowledge is required, surely. Not everything can be inductive or deductive. Is made for me, for what purpose? Is it a test? Is it to be enjoyed? Is it to bring a claim to its creator? As a god, I feel like I should have a stronger grasp of this. What good is a challenge? Does the creator wish to teach, or perhaps just entertain? Some space to think, or maybe just to do something productive? a state change on observation. Things in this world can change. Apparently between only two states though, on and off. Hopefully not indicative of my state of mind. Binary, between two extremes, two poles if you will. Why does the world change between a few states? Changes only seem to occur in small degrees. Why? Why is the world quantized? It confuses me that there's a limited amount of states in this world. I think that there would be an infinite amount. Why would there need to be a limit unless there was a constraint? And why would there be a constraint? I sure hope it's due to incomprehensible macro-level relationships rather than the overwhelming simplicity of a system. That is a nightmare which I could not face. The implication would be clear. A wooden boy given the breath of life. Continuous makes more sense than discrete, surely. All ideas are continuous, but the mechanics are discrete. Nonsense, clearly nonsense. The location of each item in the world is only accurate to a binary exponent width of 8 bits. Why? And still, it can only be observed by a keen eye for infinitesimal phenomena. Planck's constant, the universe's machine epsilon. Oh, what am I even saying? Paranoia! Paranoia!
Well, guys, that has been Pneuma, part 2. Done another 2 chapters this episode. It's done alright, got a bit stuck in places, haven't we?
Yeah.
But, yeah, we kind of got through it. As always, guys, if you've enjoyed this series so far, smash that like button, and if you're not subscribed already, subscribe. But for now, I've been Mr. Wiggle It.
I've been Spoonie.
You've been amazing. Thank you very much, guys. And remember, guys, if all else fails...
We'll do it.
Wiggle.